Hello student, myself Professor Gada Kisses from SND College of Engineering and Research Center, Yola. Student, we are learning the final year subject, that is the solar and wind energy. So from that subject, we are learning the unit number 5, that is the wind energy. So related to the wind energy, some points we have already discussed, that are what is the energy, and how the wind power plant will teaser, or how the wind power plant will generate the electricity, that also we have seen. Then energy from the winds, that's we have seen. History of the wind energy, that we have seen. That means on the wind energy, what works is done, that we have seen. Then we have seen how the wind machine works, that means how they will generate the electricity, that we have seen. Then we have seen the types of wind machines. Generally, two types of wind machines, that means the wind mills are available, horizontal axis wind machine and vertical axis wind machine. That are the two wind mills are there, which we can see in the day-to-day lives. Out of that, generally we are using the horizontal axis wind machines or horizontal axis wind mills. Generally, vertical axis wind mills are only 20% in the use on the earth surface. So different components of wind machine, that we have to see. And in the today's lecture, we are going to see the next topics, that is nothing but the wind power plants. Discussion related to the wind power plants, then wind production and wind and the environment. That are the 3 points which we are going to see in the today's lecture. So let's see what about the wind power plant. So wind power plants or wind farm, as they are sometimes called, are clusters of wind machine used to produce the electricity. That means that wind power plants are used to produce the electricity. A wind farm usually has dozens of wind machines scattered over a large area. The world's largest wind farm, the Horse Hollow Wind Energy Center in the Texas, has 421 wind turbine that generates enough electricity to power 220,000 homes per year. Unlike power plants, many wind plants are not owned by the public utility companies. Instead, they are owned and operated by the business people who sells the electricity produced on the wind farm to electric utilities. These private companies are known as dependent power producers. Operating a wind power plant is not as simple as just building a wind mill in a windy places. Wind plant owners must carefully plan where they locate their machines. One important thing to consider is how fast and how much the wind blows. That means for wind power plants, the wind availability is the main factor. So if that is a hilly area, there will be the availability of wind is more. That's why we can establish the wind power plant over there. So that is the one of the better advantage to set up the wind power plant in the hilly area. So next, as a rule, wind speed increase the altitude and over upon areas with no wind breaks. Good sites for the wind plants are the tops of smooth rounded hills, open plains or shorelines, and the mountain gaps that produce the wind funneling. So that are the spaces where wind is available easily, so we can set up the wind power plant in the such region. So wind speed varies though the country. It also varies from the season to season in the different countries. So this is because of the extreme heating of the Mojave Desert during the summer month. The hot air over the desert rises and the cooler, denser air above the Pacific Ocean rushes through the mountain, pass through it take place. So that's are some reason due to which the wines availability is more in the such region. Next we are going to see the wine production in the world. So scenario of wine production or wine energy production you should know. So in 2006 wine machine in the United States generated a total 26.6 billion kilowatt per hour year of electricity, enough to serve more than 2.4 million household appliances. That means they have produced in the 2006 26.6 billion kilowatt hour per year of electricity is produced. So after that the more electricity will be produced by using the wind power plants. That means day by day the production of the electricity by using the wind power plant is goes on increase. The wind machine generates the electricity in 28 different states in 2006. The state with the most wind production are the Texas, California, Iowa, then. So such a states where or such a countries where wine production is more in amounts. Okay, all of you understand that. So that's are some wine production history in our different countries. So wines and the environment. So as we know, wine energy is a renewable energy source, and that's why the it is a eco-friendly source of the electricity production. So in the different countries, the most serious environmental drawbacks to wines machine may be their negative effect or wild bird population and the visual impact on the landscape. So that's are one of the main drawbacks of the wine system. To some, the glistening blades of the wine mills on the horizon are on eyesore. To other, there are beautiful alternative to conventional power plants. All of you understand that? So that's are some advantages also and disadvantages also of the wind power plant. So in the today's lecture we have discussed what is the wind power plant producing the energy, how they are producing the energy, and what amount of energy will be produced with the help of wind power plant. Then we have seen wine production in the world, scenario of wine production in the world, and at the last we have seen wine and the environment. So how the impact of that in wine power plant is done on the environment, that also we have seen. Okay, so next lecture, that is the details of all the wind power plants points that we will see from the next lecture. So today we will stop here for the today's lecture.